morning, women of Africa, America, and Australia. It is, what day is it, Ruth?
The 12th of January.
And today we have the privilege of Ruth joining us. Ruth is our global intercession leader for women of Africa, women of Australia, and women of America. So she leads our intercessory on a Tuesday, and she looks after the intercessory department. And I'm honored that I get to actually share a daily devotion with her. So Ruth, welcome. Please wish a happy new year to them. You've not spoken to the ladies this year.
No, I haven't. Had a very good rest. Welcome, Women of Africa Care in Australia, America, and Africa. I believe you will have a blessed, amazing new year in prayer. Welcome, yes. Welcome.
Thank you, Ruth.
And it's a privilege to be with our Women of Africa Care CEO that's kept on air this whole time. And I believe that God has a word to impart to us today.
Absolutely. So in these daily devotions, we'll be talking about different topics as the Spirit of the Lord leads us. And today we want to be talking about spending more time with God, because January is a month where you get in touch with your spirit man, because you want the Holy Spirit to lead you for what God has planned for you for the year ahead. So you cannot get in touch with God if you don't spend time with God. I can't get in touch with Ruth if I don't spend time with Ruth. So the whole of December, she was on holiday, I was on holiday, we never got touch, we never spent time with each other, and so we couldn't connect. So if I want to know things about Ruth, I need to connect. If I need advice from Ruth, I need to connect with her. And that's the same with God. The steps of the righteous are ordered by the Lord. So if we want the Lord to order our steps, then we need to spend more time with God. And I like what Revelations 2:3-4 says. You have persevered and have patience and have labored for my name's sake and have not become weary. Nevertheless, I have this against you, that you have left your first love. So yes, many Christians that serve in the body of Christ, whether they serve full-time or whether they serve part-time, or like Sam and I, we host Wednesday cell group, and through the Friends affiliate, we host these once a month women empowerment events. You serve in the Presence Ministry, you serve in Women of Africa Intercessory, and you have a day job. And we labor. We labor a lot. We have two types of jobs, our secular job, and we serve in the body of Christ. And this is what God is saying: even though you've labored and you've not become weary, but I have this against you. You have lost your first love. You know, Ruth, last night I laid in bed, and as I went to bed, I said, Jesus, I'm missing you. I love you. I'm missing you. Please talk to me. Connect with me. I've been so busy, Ruth, doing the things for the Lord, that even though I'm praying, even though I'm interceding, even though we do these daily devotions, I missed Jesus. And last night I actually said to him, can we talk? I miss you. You know, I wanted affirmation from him. I didn't want topics about what do I need to do tomorrow for you, Lord. I just wanted affirmation. I wanted to connect. I wanted to hug him. I wanted to love on him and wanted to receive his love. And that's the sad part, that, you know, I'm sure you can relate, where we do so much for the Lord, but we forget to have a relationship with him. And I want to use another example. You know, the other day I had a disagreement with Sam, because we've been very busy doing a lot of things and we didn't spend a lot of time together. And I said to him, I've gotten so used to just serving you breakfast, serving you lunch, serving you dinner. I don't have a relationship with you. I'm just your servant. I told Sam that. I said, we don't connect. So what I had to do is, we need to regroup and now find some time for each other. So we popped into bed early and then we started talking about things. So it is so easy to miss it.
Yeah, that is absolutely true. You can be so busy with the things of God that you don't connect with God and the Holy Spirit. Father, Son, and Holy Spirit is one. You need to connect, absolutely connect in fellowship, horizontally, vertically, because you can be doing so much work for God, that you you serve, but you don't really connect, like you say, like in a relationship, like really close relationship, because you're doing the things of God, but not in fellowship with God. It is very easy to get into that rut when you serve at many. I used to serve at 7 different places all at once and work. Yeah. And you can cause spiritual burnout because then you're not, eventually you will, like their relationship, serving breakfast, lunch, supper, but no intimate relationship.
Yeah, and I eventually said to my husband, I said, you know, love, eventually we're just going to be two people living in this house and isolated from each other because we just know to serve. I mean, love language is, our love language is serving one another. But that's not the whole part of our being. So, you know, while our love language to God is serving God, if we don't know God, we will become so complacent in just serving that we will never please Him. We will never understand His heart. And then we become these dead, thoughtless, lifeless Christians. Like you say, we burn out because the passion isn't there anymore. If I keep serving Sam and there's no passion anymore, then he's just my boss and I'm his servant. We don't have a relationship. There's no passion. There's no spark. There's no romance.
Nothing.
Then eventually you lose the commitment.
Yeah, you've got to have a balance. Yes. There must be a balance in family life, in spiritual life, in your work life. And of course, we have to work. Some of us, unfortunately, although the Lord blesses us, gives us favor, but you have to have that balance. You need to set it part-time in the morning, early to hear from the Lord.
And spend spend time with Him. Set aside the needs you have. Don't look at Him to serve you only. Just say, Lord, today I'm not coming to you because I want things from you or what you want me to do. How are you, Lord? What is your heartbeat? Because, you know, God could set us last year to serve in that area. This year He's saying, baby girl, I want you to do this. But if you just focus on serving Him and you don't hear His heartbeat, you're going to miss it because the world is changing so rapidly. What we did last year is might not longer be a need this year. And so God could be shifting things around for your life. Like you said, you wanted to do intercessory globally and you never did it before. And that was your passion. And suddenly that shift came. Yes. I'm thinking about Myrtle. The other day, she said, you know, Angelina, I really would like to do intercession. She doesn't do it. She's never done it. But suddenly the shift came. If I didn't hear from the Spirit of God to say, yes, there's power in agreement, come join, I would have just let her serve in one area and not allow her to have the opportunity in another. Because all we focused is on serving. And when you love the Lord, you will understand His heartbeat. And you will do things to please Him. It's like, I love my husband. So I make rice. I make sure he's got rice every day because he loves rice. Do you understand? But if I don't have a relationship with my husband, I wouldn't know he loves rice. I like rice and I like takeaways, healthy takeaways. Sam loves his curry and rice. If I don't have a relationship with him, all I will be serving him is my rice and my takeaways and not serving him his curry and rice.
True.
Because that is what he likes. So if we don't have a relationship with Jesus, we're never going to know what he likes.
That's absolutely true. You have to have a relationship. And there is a season of serving in different areas. That's to grow you and stretch you. That's what I've learned. Serving in many different areas are a season. And sometimes you can grow in that serving area that you've done for many years. Sometimes you can just be doing it as a forced thing because it's what you know. You do not want to go out of that comfort zone. Like my passion was, as Angelina said, the intercession. But God, I didn't push it, make it happen. God made it happen. It was a suddenly because He knows the desires of your heart. So the key word here is when you serve, you must do it with passion and connection and know what is really the heartbeat of the Father. And the heartbeat comes through relationships.
Yes, true.
You know, I mean, I'm using Sam and I as an illustration for you to understand that through relationship,
yes,
we evolve in our marriage. And through relationship with God, you evolve in the things of God. I mean, with Sam, when we first got married, there was a certain pattern of how he ate food and what he wanted to eat and how I ate food. There was a certain pattern of lifestyle that we had. But as we evolved in getting to know each other, then we are able to find a new culture in our home, a new way of doing things. And as times move and as we get older, things change. And as our desires change, because we have a relationship, we know those desires change, we begin to tell each other, babe, I don't like to eat that anymore. Or love, I don't like to wear that clothes anymore. So you'll see our clothing style change. And so we change our dressing because we have a relationship where we can tell each other, you know, let's try something different. Because we have relationship. But think about it, Ruth. If all I did was just serve Sam and all he did was just serve me and we never had a relationship, he'd be keep giving me the same old food that I liked 20 years ago, which I don't like anymore, that I liked 20 years ago, and I would never explore new kinds of food. He will keep buying me clothing that I liked 10 years ago, and I've changed in dress style, but I wouldn't have known that I like these kind of dress styles now because we keep serving with the same old, not having a relationship to understand we'd like change is good. So in the relationship we tell each other, let's do some changes.
Yes, everything is subject to change as you grow older, ask me. Seasons come and go, different styles come and go, as Angelina says, in partners, but the thing is they must be able to connect and express that to one another. Like you can go to God and say to God, like Angelina said, Lord, I want more of you. I want your heartbeat. I want to connect with you. Like that is absolutely, absolutely the only way that you can fulfill the desires of your heart and express the different seasons.
Yeah. And so relationship with the Lord,
yes,
begins to help you transform for the seasons he has for you.
Mm.
No relationship, no transformation, and you'll
true.
Be serving in the same situation, in the same department, in the same way, over and over and over, because suddenly your serving has become an experience, not a revelation.
And no growth.
Yeah, you listen, every time you spend time with the Lord in relationship, there's new revelation,
absolutely,
there's new mind shifts, there's new changes, and you begin to want to do things differently. But if you don't have a relationship with God, because he goes from glory to glory.
Amen.
So like the angels, when the elders and the angels bow down, they bow down and they look up and they go, holy, holy, holy. Because every time they look at Jesus, every time they're in the throne room looking at the Father, they see a new level of glory. So every time we fellowship with Jesus, we fellowship with the Father and the Holy Spirit, there's a new level of glory. And that new level of glory teaches us and inspires us to change. We transform into that new level of glory. So the way we do things are different. The way we speak is different. The way we act is different.
True.
Suddenly new desires come. Suddenly new appetites for serving comes. But let me tell you, that is because you are spending time with God. If you don't do that and you just keep serving in the kingdom of God, you miss it because you're a servant to the purpose rather than the God that
yes.
loves you and wants you to understand that serving is awesome. It's amazing. It's passion. There's passion in it. And you can only have that passion when you spend time with the Creator that you're passionate about. Without spending time with someone you love, you can never be passionate to do things for them. So I think it's very clear here, we're saying spend more time with God. Don't ask him what do you want me to do for you today. Don't ask him what is my year ahead. Start your fast by saying,
amen,
I just want to love on you and I just want to fellowship on you. And I also want to bring one more thing up, Ruth, that I think is very, very important. That is, you know, offense is such a big thing. It's such a big thing in the body of Christ.
True.
And it will chase us away from hearing what the Spirit of the Lord has to say. Remember, the man and the woman of God that is on the pulpit or that is in your cell group or that are the people that are over you as elders, etc., they are anointed by God to be over you, to protect you, and to give you word.
Mm.
And they speak
as the Spirit of the Lord leads them. And if you get offended by them and not come to church or not go to cell group or not honor them, let me tell you the danger of that. You're actually saying, I don't want to hear from you, God. I don't want to fellowship with you God, because the Bible says, do not forsake the gathering of the saints.
That's true.
Because in corporate gatherings, we hear corporately from the Lord. How it'll come to me is different how it'll come to you.
True.
The Lord has a word for the body of Christ. The leaders have a word for the cell group. The elders have a word for the people under their care. But because you judge them, because you're offended by something they said in the carnal, you refuse to go and attend the church services or listen to what they say. And before you know it, you miss what God wants to tell you. But let me tell you, the person that is talking to you from heaven is the elder. And if you are offended by what they said, you will never receive what heaven has for you. I want to again use the example of my husband. Last week we had a disagreement and I was quite upset. And you know, as human beings, the minute couples have a disagreement, they quickly say, but you're a cell group leader, or but you're a pastor.
Yeah,
and you say those things because we are humans. And we are spirit. And if we're not, we try to be walking the spirit 24 hours, but we don't always do. And so if we don't always do, there is disagreement. And so we had a disagreement and I got upset. And then the first thing that came to my mind is, when you have cell group, in my mind, when we have cell group, I'm not going to be sitting in that cell group, because you said this at cell group, but you did something else. And you know, you didn't practice what you preached. That was what was in my head. And then so I said to God, when we have cell group, I'm just going to sit in another room. You know what the Holy Spirit said to me, Ruth? He said to me, you don't want to hear me? Are you saying you willing to go sit in another room and not come fellowship with me? Because Sam's gift is working for him.
True.
And I am the one that inspires that gift. I am the one that inspires him what to say.
Mm.
So when you say you're not going to come and sit in that cell group meeting, you're saying you're not hanging out with me. You don't want to hear what I have to say. I grieved the Spirit that day when I said, I refuse to sit in a cell group, because Sam said this on that day and he did something different to what he said. And he said, you're judging me. You're judging the things of God by what he did in the carnal. That's not right. How will you ever receive from me? Because I talk through people.
True.
We are the hands and feet of God. And so I want to bring this to you. If you are listening and you are in the body of Christ, and you go to a cell group, or you have elders over you, do not dishonor them and do not stay away from the church or cell groups or your leaders because you're offended. Because God put them there to give word. They are the shepherds that God placed over us. They hear God for us. God is a God of order. We have a relationship with God and he talks to us. But when we want corporate inspiration, we get it from the man of God. We get it from the woman of God. We have divine protection from God through our ministers, through our leaders, through our cell group leaders. We need spiritual covering, just like you need a physical home to shelter you from the storms of life. They are there, appointed and anointed by the Lord for you. God gives us manna from heaven through them. That is why God said in his word, do not forsake the gathering of the saints. If you do that, you will never get fresh manna from heaven. What do you think is going to happen? You'll be eating stale manna. What happened to the manna the next morning? It was stale. You couldn't eat it. It was rotten.
True.
So if you go to church once and you forget, you don't go anymore because you are offended by the church, let me tell you, whatever you got the last week from them is stale today. Because you know what? The manna must be replenished every day. Every day. God is not a God, even though he's a God of yesterday, today, tomorrow. His word is working every day. It is active and it is alive. How you seen the word yesterday is a totally different revelation for you today, because God has placed us in a time where the world is changing very rapidly. So what you got of Jeremiah 29:11 yesterday will be a different revelation today because of the times and the seasons. The revelation changes.
So if you have got offense towards the body of Christ and stop going to church, this is your time to repent. You know, it's sad, Ruth, that I know family members that years and years and years ago, they were speaking in that way about the revelation of God, ministering in that way. This is now like 20 years later. They still say the same thing. They haven't grown.
Yeah, because if you take offense, and some people are they serve to be a people pleaser. That is not going to it because it doesn't come out, flow out of your heart. And if you take offense and you haven't dealt with it, it becomes bitterness, it becomes unforgiveness, it stops you from receiving the blessings from above. That's what offense will do. In the body of Christ, I have experienced it personally many a time, but take two or three witnesses and you resolve the problem which I've done. And I could have left the church, I can tell you, in the 14 years many a time because of offense, or because I was serving so diligently in all seven, I cannot even name all the places I was serving at once, then I could have taken offense. But you have, that's the only way you grow, is a relationship, because it's not about you, it's not about the other person, it's actually Satan's way of causing a division and stopping you from receiving God's word and the Holy Spirit's infilling in your life to be able to do the work of God, because His word is above His name even.
Yeah.
So we can't change His word, even though the seasons change and everything is subject to change. His word never changes.
And you know, I like what you're saying also. You know, we need each other. You said earlier on that you know, we need each other. We are the hands and feet of Jesus. My hands need both hands in order to be effective, because with one hand I cannot do everything. I'm disabled and I'm gonna battle to lift up and carry. So I need two hands. And let me tell you, the two hands work together in unison. Similarly, God, when I have a personal relationship with the Lord, I have a revelation. And then when I go to church and the man and the woman of God speak, that revelation gets to a bigger thing. You know, every time we go to church, Sam says to me, you know, love, yesterday the Lord gave me this revelation, and now Pastor Theo is bringing it to another level. So imagine God's connecting the dots between what I got as a personal revelation, and He brings it out more clear and bigger through the man and the woman of God. I mean, I think about Sunday night. Pastor Jenny spoke about mirror, mirror on the wall, who's the fairest of them all. And when I look at the Holy Spirit's topics for Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, it followed in that revelation. Sweet. It got bigger, it got more meaningful, and it was more clear. So understand that when we go to church, it's because we need one another. Never think that if you're a minister or you've got a ministry, you don't need other leaders to put into your life. We all need the word. We need to be under a spiritual covering from the Father, because God gives our spiritual parents protection over us and give us the word. And when it comes to us, it is either going to clarify what the Lord has given us or make it more clear. Don't think for one second you'll know more than your parents. That is why they're the parents and you are the child. True. So similarly, don't think as brothers and sisters in the body of Christ, you don't need your spiritual mom and dad. You don't need your elders. They are there to protect you. The spiritual protection is critical, because we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against rulers, against powers, against authorities of this dark world. And how you fight that fight of faith is a spiritual battle. It's a spiritual war. It is not a physical war. That is why you need the word of God. That is why God says, do not forsake the gathering of the saints, because together we can conquer 10,000s. 10,000s. So you are not called to be isolated in your ministry or in your life journey with Christ. You need word. And you need word personally from the Lord, and you need word corporately from the body of Christ. And you need your elders covering you. Let me tell you, Ruth, the minute Crichton, our elder, came and laid, and his wife, Charmaine, laid hands on Sam and I, the very next day, the gift started working. There's power in anointing. When your leaders bless you, the Lord honors that, because it's God sees that you are submitting to the leaders, and He blesses you through them to release you to do what God has called you to do. So do not lose your first love.
Because when you lose your first love, you lose respect for the body of Christ. You lose respect for the spiritual parents in your care over you. You lose respect for your elders. And you eventually start becoming a servant that just serves with an intention to receive something. But when you have a relationship with the Lord, then you love people, whether they offend you. You love your leaders. You look up to them. You respect them. You honor them. You appreciate them. And you find new ways to serve because you know that your first love is God. You need to sit under the word. I heard somebody say to me the other day, even if you are a pastor, elder, whoever, you still need to receive the word and sit under the word. In other words, what I'm saying is you need that church covering, you need your elders, you need your cell group, you need to connect, and your one-on-one time, which is very, very important to be able, with the Holy Spirit, to be able to receive impartation so that you can have revelation of what the word is saying for you, for your season and time. Everyone's season and time is different. And when God tells you to move, then you move, but you must not move if you are offended and just move, because that will cause a major big problem in your life, and then you'll maybe regret it later. If you only, then you would say, oh, if I had only, but you did it out of offense. Do it only if the Holy Spirit tells you move or progress, season, and you hear from the Holy Spirit. And we say thank you to the body of Christ, yes, for helping us, covering us. We need to serve, not as a people pleaser or to get recognition or to say, hello, here I am, I'm doing all of this. No, it will have to be a hard passion, because you will not sustain it for long. You will only do it for maybe a month or two, not for as you need to do. Sometimes we serve and serve for many years. That is a passion. Thank you, Angelina, for this very inspirational word this morning. And I believe we need to hear it as well.
Yes, and last week we spoke about offenses, yes, you know, offenses amongst loved ones and people. Mm-hmm. If you have any offense with the body of Christ, this is your time to repent and make peace. Because when you say you're not going to church because you're offended, when you're saying you're not going to cell group because you're offended, then you're actually saying, I don't want to hear from God. I don't want to hang out with God, because God gives us word through the people that He's put in those positions. So you grieve the Holy Spirit, just like the example I used earlier on when I had a disagreement with hubby. Mm-hmm. I said I didn't want to sit in the cell group when He gives the word. And what did the Holy Spirit say? You're telling me you don't want to hang out with me because I'm the one speaking. He's just the clay vessel. I do all the talking and the inspiration. He just moves His lips. The unction comes from the Spirit of God. So don't rob yourself because you offended. Like Ruth said, go approach the person and make peace. You know, I was offended by somebody in our church, and it really troubled me because I was really hurt. So you know what I did? I sent them flowers. I sent them flowers and said, I love you. And I immediately started, my heart changed. You know, Pastor Theo, when he met Pastor Bev, she didn't love him. He said to her, every day for 2 weeks, tell me you love me, you love me, you love me. What happened? She went in that way. She loves him. She's besotted with him. She's bedazzled by him. She loves him forever, and she spoils him. So that's what happens. If you're offended by someone, just go bless them. Don't bless them. But, you know, it would be nice to talk about the offense, because then you can hear their worldview. Because you'll be very surprised that you might, what you might have thought was an offense in their side could have been a culture difference.
I've also learned to... lately that a lot of people assume things. Because somebody didn't greet you, now I'm offended. They assume things. Never assume something, because something big may be going on in that person's life. You don't know from maybe previously 10 minutes ago they got a phone call, somebody died. So never assume that they didn't greet me, they offended me, or they said something. There might be something in that person's life that they are going through, and you don't know, because you didn't connect, you don't know them that well. So now you've taken that offense upon you, causing bitterness. Now you've lost all the, well, you can't lose it, but your fruit of your spirit, love, peace, joy, and self-control and all. And then where are you? You have to do all of this and buy flowers now
Because now you, so that's my what I've learned is never assume, because people are going through a lot of challenges at the moment. Rather approach them and say, hello, how are you today? And then you find out if that offends, because now that person didn't greet me across the way there in the church. Now I'm very upset.
Yeah.
That's the way it is, truly.
So I think we've exhausted it. We've explained to you, get rid of the offense so that you can get all the things from heaven, okay? As you're making peace with your family members, make peace with the body of Christ, because they are, that the body of Christ is our stepping stone for eternal life. They help us stay on the journey and not backslide. You need them more than anything. I want you to pray this with me, okay? Father, I humble myself before you. And acknowledge that I have neglected my relationship with you. Please forgive me, Father God.
Please forgive me, Father God.
Please forgive me, Lord Jesus.
Please forgive me, Lord Jesus.
Please forgive me, Holy Spirit.
Please forgive me, Holy Spirit.
Lord.
Lord,
I've been so busy that I've lost my first love for you. I receive the grace of the Holy of God.
I receive the grace of God
to help me to develop
relationship
with my Lord and Savior Jesus Christ,
with my Lord and Savior Jesus,
with my Father God,
with my Father God,
and with Holy Spirit,
and with Holy Spirit,
who sticks closer to me than a friend. I love you, Father God.
I love you, Father God.
I love you, Jesus.
I love you, Jesus.
I love you, Holy Spirit.
And I love you, Holy Spirit.
And I thank you.
And I thank you
that I can come into your throne room.
That I can come into your throne room
to receive.
To receive
grace.
Grace
to do this.
To do this.
To build a good relationship.
To build a good relationship
with you.
With you.
Because your word says.
Because your word says.
Draw near to me.
Draw near to me.
And I will draw near to you.
And I will draw near to you.
So Lord, I'm drawing near to you now.
Yes, Lord.
And I thank you.
And I thank you
that you are drawing near to me.
That you are drawing near to me.
Thank you for a wonderful.
Thank you for a wonderful
fellowship.
Fellowship.
And getting to know you more.
And getting to know you
over this January month.
Over this January month.
Which will set the pace.
Which will set the pace.
The year ahead.
For the year ahead.
Of a fun-filled.
Of a fun-filled
love relationship.
Love relationship
with you, God.
With you.
I love you.
I love you.
Amen.
Amen. And if